Hello everyone, in our video 2 of opposition to British rule in Karnataka, we have discussed about the 3rd and 4th Anglo-Mysore war. Now next we will deal about the role of Dandiya walk. Many rebellions and protests against the British took place in Karnataka after the death of Tipu Sultan. These were armed rebellions and took place during the first part of 19th century. Among them, the rebellion led by Dandiya walk is an important rebellion. Dandiya walk was born in Maratha family of Chinnagiri. He was called as the walk, the tiger, due to his bravery. He started his career as a cavalry soldier in Hyder Ali's army and grew to the position of military general. Here cavalry means the soldier, those who are fighting while riding the horses, they are called as cavalry. Now next it is, he built his own private army and fought along with Tipu Sultan. Due to the differences with Tipu, he was imprisoned. The British released him from the prison after the 4th Anglo-Mysore War. He built a small army and started his operation. He organized the army with the unhappy soldiers of Tipu's army and the feudatory rulers who lost their power. Here, feudatory means the owners of the land, they are called as feudatories. He captured Bidnor and Shimoga forts and made unsuccessful attempts to capture Chitradurga fort. Lord Wellesley tried to check this rebellion. An attack was organized and Shimoga, Harihara and other places under the rule of Dandiya. Dandiya lost his base. After the capture of Shikaripura, Dandiya ran away towards Guthi, which was under the control of Nizam of Hyderabad. When Nizam's army attacked Guthi, Dandiya had to run towards the region of Maratha. The Maratha's army attacked him and captured most of his horses, camels and arms. In spite of this, he continued his warfare. Many unhappy plaguers, here plaguers means small territory king, they are called as plaguers. Many plaguers encouraged Dandiya walk. The French at Mahe of Malabar also extended their support to him. The British army followed him. The vast area that included Harihara, Chitradurga, Sarnur, Kittur and Londor. The British who took over the Shikharati killed many followers of Dandiya walk. Now we will see about the end of Dandiya walk. Lord Wellesley decided to end the adventures of Dandiya walk. The British requested the help of the local rulers. Dandiya has recaptured Shikaripura fort and he was scattered by British army again. The British tried to defeat the army of Dandiya, which used to move in the area between Tungabhadra and Malaparbha. They attacked him from all the direction. He was followed by them when he left Raichur. When he was caught in between Maratha army and the Nizam's army, the British attacked him near Yellaparbha and killed him at Konangal. With the death of their leader, the followers of Dandiya scattered. The British captured large chests of arms and amusements. Here, large store of arms and amusements has been captured by the British after the death of Dandiya walk. Now, next we will see about the rebellion of Kittur. Brave Queen Chinnamma, 1824. The British brought in many changes in the administration after defeating the Marathas. Tipu and Hyder Ali denying the right of adopted children over the throne was one of the such rules. The rebellion led by Chinnamma, the Queen Kittur, opposing this law is a prominent one. Kittur lies between Dharwad and Belgaum. After the death of her Malasarja, Chinnamma, the Queen of Malasarja, took active interest in the administrative matters. After the death of Malasarja, his elder son Shivalinga Rudra Sarja took over the kingdom of Kittur. Due to his falling health, Chinnamma had to take care of day-to-day administration. Shivalinga Sarja supported the British during Maratha War. As a result, the British entered an agreement with the Kittur and collected payments from him. This agreement was entered during the time of Thomas Monroy. After the death of Shivalinga, Rudra Sarja, Chinnamma adopted a boy named Shivalingappa and started ruling as a queen regent. Here regent means one who rule in place of a king. It is called as regent. Then Dhakre was the collector and the political agent of British in Dharwad. He sent a report to the governor of Mumbai and attempted to take over Kitor kingdom under the doctrine of lapse policy. In our previous video, we have discussed about the doctrine of lapse. If they don't have their natural heir, then the kingdom should be gone to the Britishers. This policy is called as doctrine of lapse. He attempted to take over the treasury and fort under his control. Chinnamma considered war as inevitable. She prepared for the war. Meanwhile, the British also prepared themselves for the war. In the battle, Dhakre was shot dead. Many Britishers were taken as the prisoners of war. The British attacked Kittur again under the leadership of Colonel Dick. The army fought the battle bravely. Chinnamma attempted to fly means escape from the battlefield, but she was captured by the British army. Chinnamma and others were imprisoned at Belingola. This is a place in Belgavi. Queen Chinnamma passed away in the prison. She has remained an ideal person till today. This is all about the Queen Chinnamma. Now next we'll deal with the Sangoli Rayana. And this rebellion has been fought between the period 1829 to 30. The name of Sangoli Rayana has remained famous along the name of Rani Chinnamma. Rayana was a brave soldier. He fought for the independence of Kittur and felt it was his duty to liberate his motherland. He fought with Rani Chinnamma and was imprisoned along with her. He was later released by the British. There are many oral stories about Rayana. He developed a sense of nationalism and went on organizing an army. He went on organizing secret meetings at sensitive geographical location. He aimed at looting the treasury and the taluk officers of the British. He had an army of 500 men. He became furious with the villagers who were assisting the British army. The British thought that Rayana was being instigate means to prove someone. It is called as instigate by Rani Chinnamma. Hence they shifted Chinnamma to Kusal prison from Belangula. The British devised a cunning strategy to capture Rayana. They encouraged Desai, who were opposing Rani Chinnamma, an alamdar named Krishna Raja joined hand with them. Thus Rayana was cunningly captured and brought down to Dharwad. Many of his soldiers surrendered after his arrest. He was declared as an offender. Offender means a criminal. Offender and was hanged till death. Many Ballads have kept the life of bravery of Rayana alive till today. Here that Ballad means a kind of a short poem. It is called as Ballad. Here we have completed about Sangoli Rayana, as well as about the Dandiya Walk and about the Kittur Chinnamma. Hope it is clear for you. If you are having any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Thank you.